Hi, today we are going to see two problems from Coulomb's law. First, we can go to first problem. Find the force of interaction between the charges spaced 1 cm apart in vacuum. The charges are 2 into 10 power minus 5 and 4 into 10 power minus 8 coulombs respectively. What is the corresponding force of interaction? We have seen Coulomb's law. Here they have given the values of charge 1 and charge 2 and the distance between the two charges. So you have to find the force of interaction between these two charges. You have to use this formula. Instead of K, you have to substitute the value 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. And finally, you have to get the force value in newtons. I have written the given data here. D is equal to 1 centimeter here, 1 centimeter apart, and Q1 here, Q2 here. So Q1 I have written, Q2 I have written. When you are doing a calculation, you have to convert all the data values, data quantities into the basic SI units. Here it is given as centimeter, you have to convert it into meter. That's why I have given a table of prefix values in last video. Then you have to find the force value. So for formula, I have shown the formula like K into Q1 Q2 by R square. Instead of R square, here I have mentioned D square. In some of the books it is mentioned as D, some of the book it is mentioned as R. And instead of K, I have written 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. This epsilon naught is nothing but permittivity of a free space which is having the constant value of 8.854 into 10 to the power of minus 12 Faraday per meter. It is the unit of capacitance, and I am substituting the value of Q1, Q2, then 4 into pi into epsilon naught value into D value, 1 into 10 power minus 2 the whole square. You will be getting this answer. You have to use the scientific calculator, then you will be getting the direct answer as like this. Now we can substitute all those values from there. 2 into 10 power minus 5 into 4 into 10 power minus 8. So I have taken a scientific calculator from the browser directly. I am going to substitute all those values. Like, first I am opening bracket for the numerator. So 2 into 10 to the power of minus 5. For 10 to the power of minus 5, I am taking 10 power x. Then you can give the power value 10 to the power of minus 5 into 4 into again 10 to the power of minus 8. So numerator value is over, then denominator. So I am going to write the denominator value 4 into 4 pi. You can directly give the value of 4 pi into 8.854 into 10 to the power of minus 12. So again I am writing 10 to the power of minus 12 into 1 into again 10 to the power of minus 2. I have opened again one more bracket because 1 into 10 power minus 2 the whole square I am giving. For giving a square or to raise to any power, you have to use this x square, x cube or x power y. If you want to do the power means directly, you can press this, it will write a power. If you want to cube it, then you can directly cube it. If you want to raise some of the number to some of the power, then you have to use x power y. Now I have pressed x square. So now I am closing the bracket. You have got the answer of 71.9091. So 71.938 I have written. Because I have submitted some other value for 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, I will tell you that. So you have got almost the same answer, 71.90. Here it is 71.938. So here it will, this exact value you will not be getting it, because some of them will be using some value instead of pi. Instead of pi, somebody using 3.14, somebody might be using 22/7, somebody will be using direct pi value like here. So it will be vary, so you will be getting an answer according to your value. So it doesn't matter, because the value 71.93, so this small kind of variation will not affect in any way. So I have written 71.9 into approximately 72 Newton. This is your final answer. And I have given one rough calculation here in this Coulomb's law problem. You will be using 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught value constantly. Instead of calculating this value and substituting it directly, you can substitute some value like 9 into 10 to the power of 9. So we can calculate the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So I am typing 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. So 4 pi epsilon naught means 8.854 into 10 to the power of minus 12. So you have got this answer 89877422438. So this I have written. So this many big number you no need to substitute it. Instead we can write this number into scientific number like 8.9 into 10 to the power of 9, because here there is 10 digits. So I am writing 8.9 into 10 to the power of 9. So again I am just making this into whole number, as 8.9 is almost equals to 9. So I am making it to 9 into 10 to the power of 9. Here I, instead of using this value, I have directly substituted 9 into 10 to the power of 9. That's why I have got value like this, 71.938. So it doesn't matter, if you want you can directly substitute this value, or you can substitute like this. However you want, you can do it and you will be getting the same answer anyhow. So you can go to the problem 2. Find the force of interaction between the charges spaced 5 cm apart in kerosene. So here it is given epsilon r is equal to 2. The charges are 8 into 10 power minus 4 and 3 into 10 power minus 6 coulombs respectively. What is the corresponding force of interaction? So this both the problem are almost the same, only small variation is there. Like 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught we have taken in last problem. Instead here we are going to take it at 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into epsilon r. Because actually in last problem also we have taken like this only, epsilon naught into 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into epsilon r. But if the permittivity of the medium is not given, then we are taking it as default epsilon r is equal to 1, because for the relative permittivity of the air is 1. So anyhow, epsilon naught into epsilon r, if you are writing it for air, is same value only, but it will vary if it is in air, or if it is in water, or if it is in kerosene, or if it is in some other oil, or it means depends on the medium, it will be getting varied every time. So here in this problem I have written the given data. So spaced distance is 5 cm. And it is given epsilon r is 2, then charges q1 q2 is given. So I have written the given data and it is given in centimeter, so I have converted into the meter. Then you have to calculate the force value. So F is equal to q1 q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught epsilon r into d square. So I have written it here. So q1 q2 by d square. Anyhow, this value is common, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught value. So we have already calculated this value, 9 into 10 power 9. So I am going to use this value, 9 into 10 power 9. Rest of the values I am going to substitute it. So 9 into 10 power 9, q1 q2 divided by epsilon r into d square value. Then again I am going to do it in a calculator for your reference. So I am substituting this 9 into 10 to the power of 9, okay, into 8 into 10 to the power of minus 4 into 3 into 10 to the power of minus 6. So you have got, sorry, I have made a mistake, 10 to the power of minus 6 only. So 21.6. okay, I have given this number, and then 2 into 5 into 10 to the power of minus 2 the whole square. If you will do square of this number, 5 square is 25, and 10 to the power of minus 2 the whole square is 10 to the power of minus 4. So 10 to the power of minus 4, 25 into 2 is 50. I have directly written the value. Now you can do divide of this number. Already this value is there. I am doing division, 50 into 10 power minus 4. I am writing 50 into 10 to the power of minus 4. You have got 4320 answer. So 4320 answer. You can separately calculate the denominator value, and then you can do like this also. That is your wish. You can do it in one single calculation, or you can just calculate for numerator, then you can calculate for denominator, then you can get the final answer. So like this you can do. So hope you have understand this problem. Next class we will meet. Bye.